Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. And we're going to start off with an AI-powered voice dictation tool that I get asked about so much. This is Flow, and it's trending this week because they raised $30 million in funding. You don't type, you speak. Kind of like this. Hi, darling. I'm thinking about dinner on Monday night. I'm thinking either Japanese, maybe an Indian, or some beautiful Italian pasta. You let me know what you think you'd like to get. I think we could make a reservation for 7 p.m. Actually, no, scratch that. Make a reservation for 8 p.m. And let's invite a couple of friends as well to a nice restaurant that has views of the River Thames. Love you, Mike. Boom, straight away, we have got a fully populated email. But what's really cool about Flow is, look at this. Not only has it written everything out really nicely, but it didn't even mention 7 p.m. for my reservation. I said, no, scratch that, 8 p.m., and it's changed it for me. So this is intelligent, but of course, I'm not just using it to write emails. I'm using it for everything, including vibe coding, that we'll get to later on in this video when we try out a couple of vibe coding tools. Now, I'm not just using this to write emails, I can also write back to members of my community hands-free. Function key triggers Wispr Flow, but if I go function and space, look at me, I'm hands-free. Now I don't even need to touch my keyboard while I talk to you. Obviously, Derek, I'm not going to post this in response because that wouldn't make sense. And look at this, this is all posted there. Obviously, I'm not going to post that into my community, but you get the idea. There are also some other cool commands, like I can hit function and control for superpowers. Make this much more funny and humorous and add silly words in the middle of my response. Now, this is known as command mode. If I hit function and control on my keyboard, like a giraffe on roller skates, now I don't even need to touch my keyboard while I frolic and bumble my words to you. This is crazy, right? And look at this, I can hit command A and then function control. Actually, just reply in a sentence, please. Wow. And immediately it's made my response to Derek concise. So I no longer need to type with my keyboard. In fact, I can probably throw this in the bin now. The voice for me has been at least 4 times faster. And frankly, anytime I try to do something now with a keyboard, I feel like a dinosaur. Oh, and the final cool thing I want to show you is hitting function and control and asking a question will launch Perplexity. Watch this. Why is the sky blue? Boom, immediately a tab opens, I'm in Perplexity, and it's answering my question. This is awesome. 30 million in funding, I can see why, and the link to test Wispr Flow out for yourself is down below. Now, full transparency, before this, I was actually testing an app called Superwhisper, which is also very good and lives up in the command dock. It's pretty much like for like, although Superwhisper has some local models that run on your machine, and you can also transcribe files with Superwhisper. So it's definitely worth doing your research and deciding which one is for you. Oh, and one last thing, Wispr Flow works on your iPhone. Just hit the globe key and the microphone. Salad, that sounds a bit too healthy, LOL. Boom, there we go. Even in informal messaging style too. What do you think of the new stylish merch? Create a magic, ship your app. It's the name of my new course where we cover a tool just like Wispr Flow and other vibe coding tools, and we ship your app in 4 weeks. I'm your technical mind, I hold your hand, and the next cohort starts this coming Monday, the 30th of June, 2025. So if you have an app idea in your mind that you'd like to get shipped by the end of the month, use the link down below, and I look forward to seeing you in the first ever cohort. Okay, onwards, we're going to check out Pythagora. They just launched 2.0, and they've got some bold claims. They are a full, all-in-one AI development platform, and you can vibe code in natural English language. They claim the tool is for technical and non-technical people. It's currently trending on Product Hunt, as you'll see here. And they make some rather bold claims, such as get rid of the toys, build real things. Get rid of endless fixing it loops, and they give you, look at this, in the pricing tiers, 10 million tokens included on the first level of paid plan. I don't know how they do that for $49 a month, but they also have a free plan, and they claim that in one prompt, you can have full stack with a database, and they have a VS Code plugin, which I did actually try out towards the end of last year. But that was version 1.0. Let's give Pythagora 2.0 a go, and I'm going to start in the web. Once I've signed up for an account, it sets up my Pythagora workspace. And boom, here we are now. For a non-technical person, I have got to say this looks a little overwhelming with all these menu items here. It looks very much like an IDE in my browser. So much more technically minded kind of tool. But let's see how it does. They claim full stack apps and one prompt. So I'm going to give one prompt and see where it takes me. I'd like you to create an app for me. As a YouTuber, I often suffer with an issue of coming up with good clickable titles for my videos. So I would like a big box where I can paste in the notes for a video I'm working on, and you will give me 5 clickable title ideas that are 50 characters or less. Also, after you've done that, I'd like a big button that gives me the option to generate 4 clickable thumbnail ideas using this image model. Okay, there we go. That is my prompt. Now, I've obviously left the space to insert an image model, so I'm actually going to do that. And I've actually just started using C-Dream 3 from ByteDance, the makers of TikTok that give you an image for just 3 cents per image. Things like this come out with beautiful text on your image, and actually I think that looks rather good. Now, Replicate, one of my favorite tools, did announce that C-Dream 3.0 has just been added, and the stunning thing about this is you can create 2048 by 2048 images. Let's feed the information to Pythagora 2.0 and see what we can make. Ah, and look at this right off the bat. Even though they say they got a free plan, it's asking me to subscribe. Well, let me do that so you don't have to. Let's go for the pro plan. Okay, there we go. Thanks for subscribing. I should get in. Mike here from the future with a slight red flag. I've looked for a way to cancel my plan after taking it out, and while I can top up tokens and pay more money, it seems scant when I look for the option to cancel. I also searched Google for this possibility, and it's taken me to a broken page. I also searched their knowledge base, but no results on cancelling the plan is found. So if you decide to sign up, beware that it may be hard to cancel. I'll let you know how I get on with this and what I hear back from the team. Even the Contact Us button on their page doesn't work. These buttons do, but I can't even contact the team. Mike here from the future again. When I try to log into my workspace now, it hangs. I did receive an email back after emailing everyone I could find an email address for at Pythagora, and they said they're cancelling my subscription and will send a confirmation, which I haven't received yet 12 hours later. And still, when I go to their website and scroll all the way down, the Contact Us link is not working. Obviously, not a great customer experience. I'm $49 down and can't use the tool. It's a shame, as I actually quite like the tool, as you'll see from this demo I recorded yesterday when I took the account out. Okay, now I paid, I can see that it's starting to work away on my YouTube title and thumbnail generator with a full app specification before it goes anywhere else. It's actually doing really well at specking out what it's going to do step by step: input video notes, generate titles, generate thumbnails. This is really good, and I love the fact it's thinking things through before we get started. It's also decided it wants to use OpenAI's API, Replicate, as I requested for the C-Dream 3 model. And it's saying, okay, are you satisfied with this description? So that was pretty quick. I'll just say yes. Okay, so next up, it's flashed up and told me it's building the front end. This may take a couple of minutes. As always in AI coding land, I just drink something and wait for my AI to complete. And wow, take a look at this. We've got a thumbnail generator being made, a title generator all in one. Pythagora seems to be working away on multiple things at the same time. And while they do say it's for non-tech people, I do still think you need to be a bit technically minded to really not be too overwhelmed by everything that's happening here. And also the fact it looks very much like Visual Studio Code and you can really dial into things. There's a lot of widgets and buttons on this screen. Now it already tells me it's loading an app preview, which is super exciting. If you like what you see so far, do throw a like and subscribe, as I do videos like this weekly. Now, this design isn't going to win any awards, but hey, it's not looking too bad. It tells me it's still looking for bugs down here. Do I want to change anything? No, I'll say I'm done building the UI. So I'm guessing at the moment we just have the front end, the page basically, and it doesn't work. Are you sure you're done building the UI and you want to start on the back end? Now, the back end for non-technically minded people is the engine to your app. It looks very pretty on the front end, but it won't do anything until you wire it up to the APIs and AI functions on the back end. So yes, let's build. And it's going straight to work. And again, it tells me it's planning the project architecture, selecting starter templates, picking technologies to use. This is all clever stuff. And it's choosing a database as well, MongoDB and Node.js as well. This is incredible. I'm guessing the Pythagora team have done a lot of work behind the scenes deciding how this would all go together. Okay, it's given me a huge implementation plan and it's writing code for the back end now. But not to worry, because here it clearly now tells me human intervention is needed. It needs an OpenAI API key and also an Anthropic API key. Okay, so I'm going to need to go to the files here in TubeGen and look maybe inside server, and there is the .env file. So this is not like for beginners, definitely. And we've got a bunch of things to put in here. Now, it hasn't asked me for anything in this section, but it has asked me for my OpenAI API key, which I can copy and paste into there. Okay, so it's popped me up a to-do list here. It says test the app by using the following steps. Open the homepage. So it says, open your web browser and visit this localhost address. So I guess I can do that. Okay, first it says open the homepage and it should load up. So yeah, step one is good. Input video notes. Okay, well, it just so happens that I've got some video notes for the video I'm presently working on. So let's copy those and paste those in. And then step three here, generate titles. So click on the generate titles button now. Click, and does it work? Well, it does. It absolutely does. Wispr better with Wispr Flow AI. Hands-free writing with Wispr Flow. Nice, nice, nice. Pythagora 2.0, build apps without coding. And they're all under 50 characters and I can copy. Copy failed though. That's not so good. And it detected that error automatically. I gotta say, I'm super impressed with that. Let's click verify titles. Check if the titles are relevant. Yes, absolutely they are. Copy to the clipboard. That's the bit that didn't work. We can input empty notes to test it. I love the way it thinks through what it's got to do. So let's put nothing in there. And yes, now we're grayed out. We can't do anything. Input something that's too long, like 10,000 characters or more. Okay, so I'll copy my notes and paste them 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's more than enough. And generate, and generation failed. Please try again. Okay, so we've got errors, which is fantastic. I guess I can click fix all. And immediately, look at this, Pythagora is going to go to work and hopefully fix those errors, bug hunt for me and sort it out. I've got to say, so far, this is a pretty slick experience. So it's got the problem analysis, it's got the solution here, and hopefully we'll get this all fixed soon. The bug got fixed up here, and we're spinning up another preview environment. And of course, step one is start the app, open homepage, video notes, and we'll go to generate titles. Hopefully we should get some nice AI-generated titles. And now, can I copy? Yes, I can copy to clipboard. This is great. Can I regenerate? Let's try and regenerate. It's detecting more errors, sadly, but at least we're doing most of what we need up front. And here we go, more generated titles that I can indeed copy to the clipboard. Now, I wonder if generate thumbnails works. Oh, it seems to be working, which is insane. If this works, we pretty much have a full stack app. Boom, generated thumbnails, and look at that. Well, I'm not sure how relevant those thumbnails are, but, you know, it generated me titles and thumbnails. Ah, and here it's noticed that it needs me to enter a replicate API token, which I didn't do before. So let's do that. And here's my space to enter it right here. And now let's see if we can generate thumbnails. The white screen of death and lots of errors. Let's fix all. So as you can see, this is not a one-hit wonder, but it does work through systematically to try and fix things. And then generate thumbnails, drum roll please. The errors are going up like pancakes. Look at that. We've got broken thumbnails. Oh dear. Oh my goodness. I seem to be pushing the fix bugs button quite a lot in Pythagora 2.0. Generate the thumbnails. And we've got placeholders. At this point, I think I'm going to give up. I managed to get the generation of awesome titles for my videos, but not thumbnails. In the interest of fairness, let's try the next new AI tool that you can use right now. Okay, Gemini, Gemini, Gemini. Yes, that's right. Gemini created a command line interface coding tool, much the same as Claude Code. This is Gemini CLI, and I did a live stream on it just a few days ago. You should check that one out too for a deep dive. But in the interest of fairness, I'm just going to paste in exactly the same prompt that I used with Pythagora to create this YouTuber tool for generating titles and thumbnails. And all I'll do in place here instead of pasting in the docs is I'll give a URL. This will be the URL to CDream 3 from ByteDance. Hopefully Gemini can do some good stuff. Let's set it to run. Now you'll see here it's actually using Gemini 2.5 Pro. And by the way, Google did a power move here. They made this free and open source, and you get 1,000 calls a day. So I've got 100% context to use in this creation. At the moment, it says I'm going the distance, planning the application, and it wants to know if I want to execute commands. So I'm just going to say yes, always. So now we're going into the power mode where it's going to roll through and create my app. Let's see how Gemini CLI does with exactly the same task. Boom, that's a lot of stuff. It's installed and it seems to be setting up the app. It's executing commands like a beast on my computer. And now we've got to the stage where it's already firing up a website. Now, while it doesn't quite look as good as what was produced by Pythagora, this looks a lot nicer. We do have a basic React app. So I'm going to try this by pasting in my show notes from this particular video and see if it actually works. I doubt it will on the first try, but let's generate titles. Okay, these are placeholders, obviously, but it's a start. What about generate thumbnails? Yes, broken link placeholders. So, okay, uglier than Pythagora and definitely no AI hooked into the back end yet, but let's see if we can get Gemini CLI to do that. Now, one thing I noticed when Gemini CLI spins up your app is it hangs. It says here that it's working away for 63 seconds, but it's not actually doing anything. It's just running my app in the background. That's a big fail that Google need to fix. So I'm going to Control C out of that and exit and restart Gemini, and then I'll tell it what I want to do next. Okay, I've got a basic holding page where I can put in my YouTube notes, but the titles generated and the thumbnails generated are placeholders. Please hook it up to the OpenAI API for title generation and the Replicate API for thumbnail generation. I'll hit enter and see if in two prompts we can get something decent. Now I see here already it's creating a .env file, much the same as Pythagora did, where it's asking for my OpenAI API key and my Replicate API key. Okay, Gemini says I've finished modifying the app. Please add your API keys to the .env file and run it. Well, I'll just tell it to run it, please. And hopefully Google Gemini CLI can do that for me, not me. And it is doing it. And it's taking me in here. This is brilliant. So now let's copy those notes and paste them in over here and then generate titles. It's taking its time. And we've got ugly titles here. Transform your writing. Well, that definitely is using AI and using, and yep, Pythagora's in there. So it's definitely using the context of my videos, but this is ugly. Now let's generate thumbnails for my video. And yes, we've got runtime errors. Okay, let's try and fix those errors because it's only fair to try fixing errors with Gemini CLI like we did with Pythagora. And now we'll paste in that error here and we'll just say on, first of all, we'll try and fix that error. First, we'll try and fix the generate thumbnails error, and it seems to be going through and it already has identified it's a problem with generate thumbnails, which is good. Here we are. Let's copy and paste those notes and we should get OpenAI generated titles, and we do. Generate thumbnails. It's loading over here for some reason, not over here, which is illogical. And sadly, although I don't get an error now, generating thumbnails just hangs forever. Now, interesting, not only is it checks things over, but it actually told me that using this is the wrong model to use because it's not a specialized thumbnail generator. It's arguing with me about my tech choices here. It says, in summary, the code technically is functional for generating images, but not using a dedicated thumbnail API. Well, thank you, Gemini CLI, for correcting me there. Here we are back in our app. Let's generate those titles and let's try for thumbnails. And okay, while it looks very, very small and not that great, we do have Master Hands-Free Writing, the Future of Programming. Yes, let's try again. See what we get. There we go. It looks like a PowerPoint presentation. One more time. And here's something that looks like a 90s software box package. I'm trying to actually kill the app and I'm getting seriously rate limited by the Google Gemini CLI. So I'm going to Control-C, Control-C. That's it. I'm done for the day. Yeah, I'm going to call it a day there. This has been a lot of fun. Gemini CLI, Pythagora. I personally this week have been using a lot of Lovable, and I'm teaching that in my new course. But you go and check out all the tools I've mentioned today in the links down below. And I really look forward to continuing the conversation with you inside my community. That's also linked up. Really appreciate you being there every week. I do love doing these demos, even if they sometimes don't always go to plan. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.